Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you comparison of CoAP and MQTT protocol. Although I have covered both of these protocols in great details in this video lecture series of IoT, but here I'll compare CoAP and MQTT protocol based on different parameters. See, here I'll be comparing CoAP and MQTT based on different parameters. First of all, one should know what is the full form of CoAP. See, CoAP is Constrained Application Protocol and MQTT is Message Queuing Telemetry Transport, right? Both of these protocols are application layer protocols. See, second parameter is architecture model. CoAP follows request response model. See, in request response model, what happens is clients are requesting for a service to server, and server will be responding to the client. So client will be sending request and server will be sending response. Request response model is there with CoAP protocol. In MQTT protocol, we have public subscribe model. See, in public subscribe model, here there will be publisher. Here there will be users or subscribers. In between publishers and subscribers, in between there will be broker. So publisher will be publishing content to the broker based on topics, and subscribers will be subscribing topic. So based on topic subscribed by subscribers, publishers will be forwarding data to subscribers, right? So here MQTT broker is forwarding data from publisher to subscriber. That is how public subscribe model is there. If you want to understand this model in great detail, you just go through my video based on MQTT protocol, in which I have explained everything in great detail, right? See, next parameter is messaging mode. With CoAP, we have asynchronous and synchronous messaging mode. Both of the modes are supported over here, while with MQTT, only asynchronous mode is there. See, in MQTT, broker will be receiving data from publisher and then it will be publishing it to subscriber, right? So that will be always asynchronous, right? While with CoAP, there can be asynchronous as well as synchronous messaging mode. See, next parameter is communication mode. In CoAP, it is one-to-one. See, in CoAP, there will be client and server. So one-to-one communication happens. But in MQTT, many-to-many communication happens. See, there will be many publisher and there will be many subscribers. So many-to-many communication happens via broker, right? So MQTT follows many-to-many communication. See, next parameter is transport layer. So with CoAP protocol, we have UDP mainly, and with MQTT protocol, we have TCP protocol at transport layer, right? See, header size of message. So that is 4 bytes with CoAP protocol, and that is of 2 bytes with MQTT protocol. So header size with MQTT is of 2 bytes, and header size with CoAP protocol is 4 bytes, right, with message. See, next parameter is message labeling. In CoAP protocol, all the messages are labeled by ID and size of ID will be of 2 bytes. While with MQTT protocol, we don't provide ID or labeling to any message. So MQTT protocol does not have any message labeling. While with CoAP protocol, 2-byte ID with message will be forwarded, right? See, next parameter is LNN effectiveness. LNN effectiveness means here how protocol is suitable for low power lossy network. So when it comes to low power lossy network, at that time, performance of CoAP protocol is excellent. But in low power lossy network condition, MQTT protocol does not give proper performance, so effectiveness is less over here with LNN. While with CoAP, effectiveness with LNN is excellent, that one can say. Even in CoAP, one can understand this. See, here one-to-one communication happens, right? So with low power lossy network, communication is possible easily, and that is one-to-one. But with MQTT, here broker is there in between, publishers and subscribers, many-to-many communication happens, right? So as if network is lossy, in that case, performance will be very weak, that one can say. right? So effectiveness is less over here with MQTT in case of LNN, right? See, shorting of data. So in CoAP protocol, universal resource identifier URI, that is shorting the data. While with MQTT protocol, broker will be defining topics, right? So shorting of data means how data is getting segregated, right? So in MQTT protocol, broker will be defining topics. It will be saying publisher, like, do you want to publish data based on this topic? So based on topic, data is getting shorted over here, right? While in case of CoAP protocol, universal resource identifier is there by which data shorting is happening, where one-to-one communication is happening, right? So that is how data shorting is happening in both of this protocol. See, next is port used. With CoAP protocol, port is 61631, right? This is port number for communication. While with MQTT protocol, there are two possibilities: secured connection and non-secured connection. See, with secured connection, port number is 8883, and with non-secured connection, port number is 1883. As well as, one should know, MQTT protocol can also handles HTTP, right? But here I'm not listing ports for HTTP, as we have already made videos based on HTTP. Here I'm just comparing content of MQTT only, right? So secure MQTT is having port number of 8883, and non-secure MQTT is having 1883 port number, right? Next parameter is persistent support. Persistent support means continuous connectivity, which we need in live, right? So here persistent support, that is not available with CoAP, while MQTT supports persistent connection with live streaming, right? Or live data communication, that is possible with MQTT. See, next parameter is reliability. Reliability, that one need to understand based on how communication happens, right? When it comes to CoAP protocol, at that time I have explained how that functions. See, there are four categories of messages. First is confirmable message. Confirmable messages are reliable message. So with confirmable message, there will be always response. That response can be given by acknowledgement message, as well as that response can be given by reset message, right? And as if message is not getting forwarded properly, then there is a possibility of retransmission, right? So as if response is not coming, then retransmission of message happens in case of confirmable message. In non-confirmable messages, you don't have retransmission, right? That is how reliability is there with CoAP. But when it comes to MQTT protocol, then there is three different services. One is delivery not guaranteed. So as if you don't need to provide guaranteed delivery, then you can have this service. Second is delivery confirmation, in which responses will be there. And third is delivery double confirmation. Means here we will be taking double confirmation of transmission of data. So in terms of reliability, more services are available with MQTT compared to CoAP, that one can say, right? So that is how MQTT and CoAP protocol differs with respect to each other based on different parameters. I hope you have understood this session. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.